You promise your child they can be anything they choose. They promise to follow their dreams. Our promise is to help you save for college today and every day worry-free. YouPromise.com lets you save extra money for college by doing the everyday things you already do. Link any college savings plan with a free YouPromise account and watch your child's dreams become their future. Sign up today at YouPromise.com for a $30 welcome bonus. Start now at YouPromise.com.
This is CBS Eye on the World with John Batchelor. Here's John Batchelor.
This is CBS Eye on the World. I'm John Batchelor. It's a pleasure to welcome the Chief Science Officer and co-founder of Cloud to Street, Beth Tellman, who is also a professor at the University of Arizona Geography. We are applying ourselves to the planetary geography for the crisis of flooding. You will recall recently flooding in China with incomplete results causing deaths and dislocation of hundreds of thousands dislocated, large numbers dead, and a damage to the immediate territory of the floodplain. But flooding in China is as old as the Chinese emperor. And we turn to the surprise of flooding in Germany, a country associated with pastoral farmland, catching the German farmers completely by surprise one evening, crowding in their second floor or third floor for the damage that was being done to their village and their way of life. Those two events lead us to the question of, can we anticipate? Can we learn? Professor, a very good day to you. Your study, satellite imaging, reveals increased proportion of population exposed to floods, appearing in the peer-reviewed Nature magazine, the premier magazine for science in Europe, matching science here. This is a revelation to me, but you've been watching this story for some time. So let us begin with your tools. What is MODIS? What is AQUA? What is TERRA? Good evening to you, Professor.
So thanks so much for having me. So let's talk about MODIS, AQUA, and TERRA. So AQUA and TERRA are two satellites operated by NASA, and there's actually a lot of different instruments collecting information about the Earth every day on these satellites. They circulate the globe and give us information about the entire planet twice a day. And one of the instruments mounted on each of these two satellites is called MODIS. And MODIS is an optical sensor that is you can think of it as taking pictures of the Earth, although it's collecting much more information than what you can see with the visible eye. It's collecting information on longer and shorter wavelengths of light in the near infrared, shortwave infrared, and even the thermal spectrum. And with all of this information we capture from the sensor, we can identify unique objects on Earth, like water from major flood events. So that's what I've been using this instrument to capture on the planet.
You're using hard data of floods themselves. Now, there are limitations that are important to explore, but the overall concept, if I understand correctly, Professor, is that heretofore we've had modeling to provide information to the global flood database. You're still dependent in some instances on modeling because the satellites can be blocked by cloud cover, but you're providing data of actual events to augment the global flood database. I hope I say all that correctly, because we go to the way you've compiled these events. News reports. How very practical of you. People report floods. This is over a period, do I say correctly, 2000 to 2018? Is that the window that you're looking at?
Correct, yes.
In that window, you find news events in the 3,000s. The actual number is more than 3,000. You have 12,700 images taken by MODIS to compare and contrast. You then have to eliminate 2,000 images because you can't see through them. You come with 913 events. Is this the first time anybody's had hard data like that, Professor? 913 observed from space flood events?
This is the first time we've had it on this scale and order of magnitude. But scientists have been mapping floods with satellites for a really long time. In fact, the scientist who compiled the database of news events, Bob Breckenridge at the University of Colorado, has actually been doing this since 1985, looking at news events from floods around the world and using satellites like MODIS or Landsat to make maps of them when possible. But it's never been done systematically on a global scale for all of the events that have been recorded. So what we did for the first time was try to map all of the events in this database. So the scale is really what's unprecedented here.
At 250 meters, which is close to look at a flood. So you're getting really good information. There are limits. I mentioned them. The limits are that MODIS itself, it can be blocked by cloud cover. And you have a parallel mission, which is to identify populations at risk and how they've changed over this time period of 2000 to 2018. How did you do that? Using MODIS as well?
Yeah, so what we did is we mapped all of the floods that we could over about the past two decades. And in all of these areas where we could see water, we then looked to see how many people were estimated to be living in these inundated areas in the year 2000. And then compare that to how many people were living there in the year 2015. What was that rate of change in this inundated area? We then compared that for each country to its population growth rate. And what we're really trying to see here is, you know, of course, population is going to grow over 15 years. But we wanted to know, is it growing faster in floodplains than the population growth rate of that country? Because that would indicate a big problem. Not just that families are growing, but that people are moving into floodplains. And unfortunately, that's what we saw in a majority of countries around the world. We saw an increase up to 24% in the proportion of population exposed to floods. So we're on a trajectory, on a tendency of people to move into places that we have seen flood just in the past 20 years.
What causes a flood? Logic suggests water. Yes, of course. But where does it come from? And in addition, your tracking includes, has limits. For example, rainfall causes floods. I understand that. What is a pluvial event? What does that mean, Professor?
Yeah, so a pluvial event would mean that's a rainfall flood event, actually. So we know in you've maybe experienced this in a major city where it rains so hard that the water overwhelms the sewer system. And so you begin to have a flood. So a lot of flood events are riverine floods where it rains along the watershed and the river banks start overflowing. That's common. But a pluvial event, very common in urban events, describes in urban areas, describes this phenomenon of rainfall overwhelming the infrastructure system.
Yes, if I understand, there's a caveat here. You cannot necessarily track every flooding event. For example, dam breaks are hard to track. Pluvial events are hard to track because they're sudden. And snow melt is hard to track. So there are limitations here, but the satellites are giving us data. One more detail here, because we're going to go to the results as if I understand them. These news events, you had to concentrate the news events globally, 2000 to 2018, and you have spatial resolution, but you have some limitations in your mapping, if I understand correctly. Are the news events regarded as accurate? Are you happy with them? Because when a local news reporter writes a flooding event in his town, it doesn't necessarily, he doesn't have satellite immediately. What is your thinking about that? The flooding in Germany, for example, came to areas that had never, you know, 500-year floods, 1,000-year floods. So are the news events trustworthy? What do you think of them?
Yeah, good question. So what we actually used, well, what the Dartmouth Flood Observatory uses, which is where we got this database of media events, are usually really large flood events that have been verified by multiple news sources. So we do think the events that we're mapping are real. The larger concern is the bias we're getting in reporting. This is on extended data figure 9 of the paper, which is you can only see in the online version, but we actually have a map. And you can see in blue, a lot of countries light up where we have a lot of reporting on floods. The US, China, Europe, Australia, Brazil. But large swaths of the world, you'll see countries colored in red. Sub-Saharan Africa, Latin America, some parts of the Middle East, indicating that we have underreporting probably from damaging flood events in those cases because of a lack of large media coverage for them. So it's the coverage and the lack of events in those regions that is more concerning to me.
I'm speaking to Beth Tellman, Professor Beth Tellman of the University of Arizona, the Geography Department. She is also simultaneously publishing in Nature magazine about flooding, flood tracking over these early years of the 21st century. She is Chief Science Officer and co-founder of Cloud the Street. When we come back, what have we learned so far? What does it tell us about the immediate future, the next decade? This is CBS Eye on the World. I'm John Batchelor.
Saving starts with internet and wireless from Xfinity. Because when you get Xfinity internet and add mobile, you can save up to $400 a year on wireless. Enjoy fast, reliable internet at home and nationwide 5G on the go, included at no extra cost. Get Xfinity internet and mobile together and ask how to get an eligible 5G phone on us. And for a limited time, $300 back. Don't miss out. Go to Xfinity.com/start saving. Call 1-800-XFINITY or visit a store today. Restrictions apply. Savings based on optimized pricing. Actual savings may vary.
¿Estoy embarazada? First Response sabe que esta es una de las preguntas más importantes que una mujer se hará a sí misma. Es por ello que las pruebas de embarazo First Response detectan no uno, sino todos los tipos de hormonas de embarazo, dándole una respuesta con una precisión superior al 99% a partir del primer día en que no tuvo su periodo. Las pruebas Early Results y Digital Pregnancy detectan todas entre las hormonas más importantes de embarazo generalmente encontradas en el orín.